गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आयशा सुल्ताना. वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ एनालॉग कम्युनिकेशन. इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डीमोडुलेटर्स ऑफ योर एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक्स. ओके, बिफोर गोइंग टू दैट टॉपिक वी विल जस्ट रिवाइज व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास. लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन अबाउट द मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक्स और द मॉड्यूलेशन प्रोसेस फॉर डेवलपिंग और क्रिएटिंग योर एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन. सो वी हैव टू काइंड्स ऑफ मॉड्यूलेटर्स, राइट? For the generation of your amplitude modulation, there are two methods. That are first one is square law modulator and switching modulator, right? So what was your square law modulator? What the things you had there? You require a summer which is used to combine your message signal as well as the carrier signal, which is given to your square law device. That is nothing but your non-linear element or diode or a transistor. So we are using the diode here. Then it is given to a band pass filter. Why we are using a band pass filter? Acts to remove the unwanted signals which are occurring. We only need a conventional amplitude modulating signal. So we are removing all the unwanted signals. Only the amplitude modulated signal or the modulated signal is extracted by using a band pass filter. So that was about your generation of your amplitude modulation. So you have seen square law modulator and switching modulator. So out of that, both the square law modulator was the one which was very what similar type of amplitude modulated signal will be obtained. So now we'll see what are the demodulation techniques. Okay, the process what actually this demodulation defines, right? So the process of extracting an original message signal from the modulated wave is known as your demodulation. What it means? What you are sending, what the transmitter is sending from your side, from the transmitter, what you are getting from the transmitter side is your modulated signal. That is nothing but the combination of your carrier as well as the message signal, but it is coming through a particular channel with some distortions also. So what actually demodulator or the detection or the demodulation should do, it should extract the only original message signal, means your low frequency message signal that has to be extracted from the modulated wave, and that process is known as your demodulation or detection process. And the circuit which operates all these things is known as your demodulator. The circuit which demodulates the modulated wave is known as your demodulator. Here also we are having two kinds of techniques. First one is your square law demodulator and the second one is your envelope detector, or the square law detector or envelope detector. These are the two techniques that we will be seeing in today's class. Okay, so what is demodulation? The process of extracting the original message signal from your modulated wave is called as demodulation, and the device which does or the circuit that completes this technique is called as your demodulator. And how many types of you are having detectors or the demodulators for demodulating your AM wave? That are two. That is, first one is square law demodulator and the second one is envelope detector. So first we'll go for the square law demodulator or detector. In the square law demodulator, see, this demodulator is specially used for low level amplitude modulated wave. Means you are having low modulated, very low modulated amplitude wave is there. So for that kind of, to extract the original message signal from that kind of amplitude modulated wave, we are going for the square law modulators or demodulators. Okay, and the block diagram of your square law demodulator consists of this square law device and a low pass filter and the demodulated output. The square law device what you are having here also will be using a diode. Okay, the amplitude modulated wave is given as the input signal to this one. Okay, and that input is again given to the low pass filter to remove the unwanted signal and only to give the original message signal, which is a low frequency signal. Clear? We'll see. So this demodulator contains of your square law device, as I have told, and it also contains of your low pass filter. The amplitude wave which is given as V1 of t, that is applied to the demodulator input. So first, what input we are giving? V1 of t is nothing but it is will be the modulated output, means it will be the combination of your message signal as well as the carrier signal. So what was your conventional amplitude modulated waves equation? V1 of t is equals to AC of 1 plus KAM of t into cos 2πfct, the original modulated wave. I hope you people remember what this is. Nothing but your amplitude modulated wave. So this is given as, obviously this should be given as the input to your demodulator side, right? So this is the standard AM wave is given as the input to your demodulator. This is the first one. Okay, now we know mathematically what is the output of the square law device. V2 of t is equals to VK1 into V1 of t plus K2 into V2 of t. This we are considering by why we are considering this, because of the non-linear device that we are using. The non-linear device equation is given in terms of K1 into V1 of t plus K2 into V2 of t plus K3 into V cube of t, so on we have taken, right? So here also we are using a non-linear device, and the mathematical relationship between your input and output of a square law device is always given as V2 of t is equals to K1 into V1 of t plus K2 into V square 1 of t. This is not V2, this is V square 1 of t. This is the equation 1. So what you have to do, you have to substitute the value of V1 of t, and in the place of V square we have to do the squaring of this one. I'll explain over here. So what is here, where V1 of t is the input of your square law device. This we already know. What is V1 of t? Is nothing but your amplitude modulated wave. This amplitude modulated wave is given as input to your square law device, right? Now second one is V2 of t. What is V2 of t? V2 of t is nothing but the output of your square law device. I'll go back and show you. Here this is V1 of t is your AM signal that is given to the square law device, and this V2 of t is the output of your square law device. What is V2 of t? V2 of t is equals to K1 into V1 of t plus K2 into V1 square of t, correct? So this is your V2 of t is the output of your square law device, where K1 and K2 are constants. Clear up to here? Now what you have to do, you have to substitute the value of V1, that is amplitude modulator signal, into the equation 1. What is the equation 1? That is nothing but the output of your square law device. See here clearly, I have given here V2 of t is equals to V1 of t. What is V1 of t? K1 into AC of 1 plus K1 into AKA M of t into cos 2 pi FCT. That is nothing but K1 into V1. This is your V1, correct? Now K2 into V2 square we have to do. V1 square of t. What is V1 square? That this is AC of 1 plus KA M of t into cos 2 pi FCT whole square. See, this solving of this equation is very important. In the next slide, I have shown clearly how you have to solve. Please do listen very carefully so that you can understand this process. Okay, what you are doing, first you are giving the amplitude modulated wave, the input, that is the modulated signal, as the input to your square law device. That is V1 of t is the input to your square law device. V2 of t is the output of the square law device. Now, because it is having non-linear characteristics, how we are giving the square law device output? V2 of t is equals to K1 into V1 of t, again K2 into V1 square of t. You have to substitute the values of V1 of t in the equation 1, that is V2 of t, you have to substitute the values. Now see the equations, how we have going through. Okay, now V2 of t, I am separately multiplying this one, this term. K1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT you will get here. Then K1 KN KA M of t into cos 2 pi FCT. See here, K1 into AC cos 2 pi FCT plus K1 AC KA M of t into cos 2 pi FCT. This was the first equation. Now what I'll do, I'll separately multiply the second part also. What I'll be having, K2 is common, that is the outside constant term. Now next, AC is there, no? This is AC cos 2 pi FCT. I'm multiplying this one, and this whole part is your A and this whole part is your B after multiplying this. See here, listen very carefully. AC cos 2 pi FCT, the first part, plus AC KA M of t into cos 2 pi FCT. This is the second part. Whole square will be remaining same, and K2 is also same. Now this is equation similar to of A plus B whole square. Yes or no? You will be having A part and B part. So what is the formula for the A plus B whole square? A square plus B square plus 2AB. correct? So what is the formula? This first part I am keeping same as it is, okay? K1 into AC cos 2 pi f ct, okay? Then plus K1 AC KA m of t into cos 2 pi f ct plus, now what is A? K2 is common, so similarly like here I am taking it a common. What is A square? A square is your AC square, okay? Cos square of 2 pi f ct plus, what is B square over here? AC square KA square m square dot matlab, into cos square 2 pi f ct, correct? Then the third one is 2AB. What is 2AB here? What is 2AB over here? 2 into AC cos 2 pi f ct into AC KA m of t into cos 2 pi f ct. This is a A plus B whole square formula. It is clear or not? Okay, in case of you are having any doubts, please let me know. Afterwards, see the next equation. What you are having over here, the first part I will be keeping the same one. That is K1 AC cos 2 pi f ct, see here, then plus K1 AC KA m of t into cos 2 pi f ct plus. Now see, what is the formula for the cos square A? Isn't it the form of your cos square A? Cos square A is equals to 1 plus cos 2A by 2. What is A over here? That is nothing but your 2 pi f ct. So what you have to write here? I'll take out the common terms of your cos square A. See here, AC square cos square 2 pi f ct. Then I am having AC square KA square M square into cos square 2 pi f ct. Now here see, 2 AC square AC into AC, AC square, then cos 2 pi f ct, cos 2 pi f ct. What I will get? Cos square 2 pi f ct into KA M of t. And I will substitute this value in this equation. What is the formula for cos square A? 1 plus cos 2A by 2. What is A? 2 pi f ct. So what is the overall equation I will be getting? 1 plus cos 4 pi f ct by 2, because 2 into 2, that is 4. Okay, I hope you are clear with this part. Okay, now see, I am substituting these values here. Then what are the equation I will get? See, the first part is same. K1 AC cos 2 pi f ct plus K1 AC KA m of t cos 2 pi f ct plus, here I am substituting the value of which one, which equation I am substituting? Cos square A. What is cos square A? 1 plus cos 2A by 2. Now substitute the value of cos 2A by 2. What I will get? 1 plus cos 2 into 2, that is 4. 4 pi f c by 2. Yes. So K2 AC square 1 plus cos 4 pi f c by 2 plus KA square M square into 1 plus cos f c by 2, 4 pi f c by 2 plus 2 KA M of t into 1 plus cos 4 pi f c by 2, where your K2 is already common over there. Right, so this is the overall equation. If I take common term, what I'll get? K1 AC cos 2 pi f ct, the first part will be same, then second part K1 AC KA m of t into cos 2 pi f ct plus, I'll take the common term K2 AC square 1 plus KA square, okay, m square. This what I'm taking common is 1 plus cos 4 pi f ct. I'm taking common. See what I'll get? First part, this one will be same, okay, so I will keeping it as 1 only. So 1 plus cos 4 pi f ct, this is common, AC square I will be getting. Next, what is the second term? KA square m square of t, second part KA square m square of t into 1 plus cos 4 pi f ct, this I have taken common. Third part was plus 2 KA m of t, plus 2 K m of t. What is the common term I have taken? 1 plus cos 4 pi f ct. I hope you are clear with this thing. What is the formula what you are using here is cos square A, that is equals to 1 plus cos 2A divided by 2, and the value of A is equals to 2 pi f ct. Now removing the unwanted signals, in this above equation the term K2 AC square KM of t is the scaled version of your message signal. This scaled version of your message signal is extracted by using your low pass filter. The low pass filter which we have used next to your square law device is there, no? To that one, from that particular low pass filter, we are extracting the scaled version of your message signal, and that message signal is your original message signal. Okay, this is how you will be getting your original message signal or the scaled version of your message signal by using your demodulator device, right? So this demodulator, this square law demodulator allows your distortionless recovery of your message signal. But what the condition should be? Your amplitude wave should have low percentage of modulation. At the initial, at the starting of this topic only, I have said that this square law demodulator is mainly used for low level of amplitude modulation. Means it should be less modulated when compared with the other modulation. So this square law demodulator is having distortionless recovery of your message signal, but the condition should be there that your low level percentage, means low modulation, has to be done. I hope you are clear with this square law demodulator. Now the second part is your, the second one is your envelope detector. In the name itself, you can know what is the envelope, what you have said in the amplitude modulation. The part, the amplitude of your message signal should be same. The envelope should be same. Okay. So this envelope detector is used mostly in your high level amplitude modulation. High level amplitude modulation means where your modulation index or the modulation is more. You have more modulated your message signal or your carrier signal. So whenever your modulation level is high at that particular conditions or at that particular circuits, you will be using these envelope detectors. Okay, these envelope detector circuit whose output follows the envelope of your modulated signal, which is used to reproduce your modulating signal or the message signal, and that is called as your envelope detector. So the main agenda here is we have to see the proper envelope is coming or not. In case if there is no proper envelope, either it is more or less. If it is less, your message signal or the information is lost. If it is more, the distortion will be more. Okay, so we have to check whether your envelope is proper or not. So for the proper checking and proper getting the message signals, we are going for the envelope detector. So because of simplicity and moderate cost or the less cost, it is most popularly used envelope detector in your amplitude modulators or amplitude modulated signals. This detector is widely used. Okay, and this is used where? This is used for high level amplitude modulating signals. Clear? Now see next one, the block diagram of your envelope detector. Again same, you are having the two devices over here. The input will be your modulated signal, which modulator? Amplitude modulated signal, and that is given to your diode. Here we are using a diode, means it will be acting like a on or off switches, right? So we are using a diode over here. Now next, after passing to this diode, we are passing it through a low pass filter, where you will be getting your model, means your output will be obtained. What is the output? What you have to get here? Original message signal. Demodulated means original message signal has to be obtained. So the low pass filter, we here the low pass filter contains the parallel combination of your RC circuit. What is my resistor and the capacitor circuit. Now what is the input? What you have given? The standard amplitude modulated wave signal is given as AC of 1 plus KA m of t into cos 2 pi FCT. This is the standard form of your amplitude modulated wave. This we are giving to the diode as the input. Now because it is acting like a switch, and we are having what you are having? RLC circuits. So in this one, during the positive half cycle, the input signal, the modulated signal of the diode becomes in forward bias. Okay, during the half cycle, during this half cycle, this diode will be in your forward biased condition. So what happens? It conducts. So whenever it is conducting, the capacitor over here gets charged, right? So whenever the capacitor is getting charged, the peak value of the input signal will be reaching here, correct? So we'll be getting a proper envelope. So if there is a proper envelope, then there is no loss of the signal. Okay, this is at the positive half cycle. Okay ma, whenever you are having the positive half cycle of the input signal, the diode will be becoming in the forward condition, forward bias condition, and then it will start conducting. Whenever it start conducts, so what happens? The capacitor gets charged, right? I hope this is clear for the positive half cycle. When the input becomes, whenever the input signals or the amplitude modulated signal falls below the peak value, the diode becomes in the reverse bias. Now this diode goes into reverse condition when it's going to the lower value or the negative value. Okay, when it starts falling. okay, when it start falling, it goes into the reverse bias and the capacitor slowly discharges. But the condition here is the capacitor should charge fastly and it should discharge very slowly. As to get the proper envelope, the capacitor, the condition should be there that it should be charged fast and it should be discharged very slowly. So the amount of discharge depends upon the constant time which we are using over here. So there are the two conditions which are given for the charging and discharging of the capacitor. The first condition is during the condition for the charging is during this charging time the constant value, that is RS constant or the RC, must be less when compared to your carrier time. This is the condition. Your RC value should be less than your carrier frequency. Then at that particular time, what happens? The charging will be very slow. Okay, the discharging time constant, RLC circuit, should also follow the one more condition, that your carrier frequency should be less than your RLC circuit, and that should be less than your bandwidth that you are using. Okay, the bandwidth which you have used. See, I'll explain once again. The amount of discharge depends completely on the time constant of your RC circuit, this particular circuit. During the next positive cycle, the signal, the modulated signal, again the diode conducts, again the capacitor, again it will be charging. After some time, whenever it is coming to the negative cycle, it starts discharging, right? So this is the condition where you have to see. So this cycle or this process is completely repeats until the output follows the envelope of the input. This cycle, you might get a doubt that this cycle, up to which time we have to repeat this cycle? Positive half cycle, negative half cycle, then diode starts, diode is in forward bias and reverse bias, capacitor charges and discharges. This cycle completely ends up to when? Up to whenever you are getting the same envelope of your message signal. Till that time you have to repeat this cycle. Whenever you get the proper envelope, the same envelope as of your message signal, you have to stop the repeating of this process. Clear? So the capacitor charges up to the peak value of the input, and this process is continuously repeated until the output follows the envelope of the input. So this circuit is completely called as your envelope detector. Okay, see, in case if say this is your input signal and this is the proper envelope, in case if you are not getting the proper envelope, or what we'll say, your charging, your capacitor discharges very immediately, so what happens here, the part over here, the message signal is clipped out. Okay, so if it is clipping out, means the message will be lost. So this is the condition. And if it is not discharging very slowly, or your time, your value is very high and your envelope is more than that of your message signal, of course there will be a distortions which will be added to your message signal. So we should see that there should be a proper condition that your capacitor charges immediately, but it should discharge very slowly. And these are the two conditions that you have to follow for the charging and discharging. For the charging, the time constant should be less than your carrier frequency. And for the discharging, your time constant RLC circuit should not be long enough to ensure that the capacitor discharges very slowly through the resistor RL, which is in between your positive peaks or the negative peaks. Clear? I hope you are clear with today's topic. Okay, this is how your capacitor charge or discharge. See, we should select this component in such a way that the capacitor is charging quickly and discharges very slowly. And the results of this particular one, see, if your RC is too large, as I have said, if your envelope is too large, then what happens? It will be more than that of your message signal's peak. So in case here, there is a chance of getting the distortions over here. If it is not, your RC is too less, then it will be going inside the message signal, then this part will be clipped out. So you have to see the condition, proper condition should be there that your envelope is proper. This cycle should be repeated until you get the proper envelope or the same envelope as of that of your message signal. So that will get the capacitor voltage waveform will be same to that of your envelope of your amplitude modulated wave, which is almost similar to that of your message signal or the original signal or the modulating signal. clear? I hope this is clear. This topic, so what are the today's topics? Demodulation techniques or detection techniques of your amplitude modulated wave, where we are having two categories. First one is switching modulator. First part is your, what is the first demodulation technique? Square law demodulator, and the second one, envelope demodulator. In square law modulator, this is mainly used for the low level amplitude modulation, whereas your envelope detector is used for high level amplitude modulated signals. Correct? So in square law detectors, distortionless recovery of the message signal is obtained because we are not finding any envelope. Plus the condition is that there is low level of your modulation, low percentage of modulation should be done. But whereas for the high level of modulation, if modulation is very high, then we are going for the envelope detector. And the most widely used detector for the amplitude modulation technique is your envelope detector. There you are having a RC circuit and a diode. In the positive half cycle of the diode, your capacitor charges, which is in the forward bias condition. Whenever in the negative half cycle, the diode is in a reverse bias and it discharges. But the condition for getting the proper envelope of your message signal is that the capacitor should charge fast and it should charge discharge very slowly. Okay, so this is the condition where you'll be getting the original exact envelope of your message signal, and there at that condition only we won't get any kind of distortions in your message signal. I hope you are clear with today's topics. In case if you are having any doubts, please let me know. Okay, so for today's class we'll end the section till here itself. Thank you.